हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे राम हरे राम 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 हरे। श्रील भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती गोस्वामी प्रभुपाचर ऐ नंद तनुज किंकर पतितांगा विषय भवाम्बुधो कृपात पाद पंकजस्तुतिदृश विचित फ्रॉम शिखाष्टकम वी फाइंड दिस श्लोका। एक्चुअली आई वुड लाइक टू एक्सप्लेन दिस थिंग, you should know it very clearly that Sikhashtak, I mean 8th sloka given by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, actually all Goswamis, those our Goswamis, they write thousands of books, hundreds of books. Actually all those books, you see, actually many books written by our Goswamis, previous Acharyas. Actually Prabhupada telling that those books are the actual explanation of that, of those 8 sloka. 8 sloka actually explained in details in different books, everything. That is the main thing. And Madhavendra Puripad, today is the vital auspicious day, actually Chandan Yatra Utsav. Oi Dindayal Donatai Mathuranath Kadavalakasya Hidayam Tadaloka Kataram Daito Brahmati Kim Karamiham. Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Prabhupada telling this sloka by Madhavendra Puripad, actually it is the key of Rupanuga Bhajan. Prabhupada telling actually this sloka by Madhavendra Puripad, we Gauriya, it is the key if we want to enter into Rupanuga Bhajan, Raganuga Bhajan. This is the key, very important sloka. Same sloka I told from Sikhashtak, very important sloka. Actually is the feeling of separation, deep separation. This sloka actually is the deep expression of separation. Our Gauriya Bhajan is full of this mood, totally. Our Gauriya Bhajan is totally full of this mood. If we lose this mood, we cannot get Nanda Nandan Krishna, we can get Narayan. Prabhupada telling somebody worshipping Krishna inside temple, Krishna, Radha Krishna there. Somebody worshipping there. Prabhupada telling, it seems that he is worshipping Radha Krishna, but actually he is worshipping Narayan, Lakshmi Narayan. Why? Why you say like this? Inside temple there is Radha Krishna. Well, maybe Radha Krishna, but when he is worshipping, that it become the worship of Lakshmi Narayan. Because anyway, his mood is not free from opulences. His mood is not at all free from opulences. See, some sort of ego, some sort of Oh, yes, Supreme Lord, oh, I am worshipping. And in Chaitanya Charitamrita it is written, to serve Krishna, to love Krishna, only the quality we need, we must have tremendous, tremendous attraction for Krishna. If Narayan is there in front of me, if Narayan appear, I said, no, I don't need. I don't like to meet him. I like to meet. Like same case, you know, in Govardhan, when actually in Chandra Sarovar, it crossing Chandra Sarovar, if you go to Eta Peta, one nice place, where Krishna, Eta Peta place, you can get the Narayan deity there. It is from Chandra Sarovar, you will have to go more, two, three kilometers more. There you can get Eta Peta place, this village, Eta Peta. Have some reason I can speak after. Actually there, we find one Narayan deity, nice, very good. When Krishna disappear, when Radharani disappear from Rasa Leela, then Krishna become mad. When Radharani disappear from Rasa Leela, then Krishna become mad. Where is Radha? Because maybe there is so many gopikas. But without Radharani, Rasa Leela cannot stand. I am not going to explain Rasa Leela actually. My point is different. Radharani is the binding force of whole Rasa Leela. Radharani is the center point of whole Rasa Leela. Radharani is the binding force of whole Rasa Leela. If Radharani is not there, no Rasa Leela. It breaks. Then Krishna searching where is. Krishna also disappear. When Radharani disappear, then Krishna also disappear to search where is Radharani. Then those gopikas, they all gone mad. Oh, where is Krishna? Where is Radharani? Then in Bhagavatam it is written, whole night they are searching from one village to another. One forest to another. Vrindavan, 12 forest and sub-forest also there. It is written in Bhagavatam, those gopikas, they are searching for Krishna. Where is Krishna? From one forest to another forest, they are running like crazy. Actually, it is written in Bhagavatam that those gopikas, they are searching Krishna. And the way, how they are searching? In Bhagavatam it is written, Bichikyur Unmattaka Bad Banat Banam, in Sanskrit. Bichikyur Unmattaka Bad Banat Banam, from one forest to another, where is Krishna? Where is Krishna? They are asking those trees, you have seen Krishna going through this place? See deer, you see? Have you seen Krishna going through this place? Oh Jasmine, oh Malati, have you seen Krishna going? Oh Tulasi, have you seen Krishna going through there? Where is our Krishna? Please save our life. Please give indication so that we can go that way and search Krishna. Otherwise our life is already going. We cannot live anymore. This is the mood of separation. When they are searching, those gopikas, suddenly they are going to Govardhan and Govardhan, that whole place is Govardhan, actually near Govardhan there's that village I told you, Eta Beta. There suddenly is those gopikas looking, oh, there is Narayan, forehand Narayan, Krishna cheating, Krishna want to cheat those gopikas, Krishna manifest four hands, Narayan. Then gopikas coming here, oh, this is Narayan, Namo Narayan. We are searching for Krishna. Wait. But at last when Radharani is searching Krishna, when coming, approaching near and near, when Krishna want to maintain four hands, when well, the more Radharani approaching, then Krishna become fighting. When Radharani coming, then two hands going inside and two hands. That is the power of Radharani. You see, in front of Radharani, Krishna cannot do anything. So powerful love. I wanted to clarify this point. When Pope was saying inside temple that Brahmachari is worshipping actually Radha Krishna, people say actually he is worshipping Lakshmi Narayan. He cannot worship Krishna. To worship Krishna, actually we need Rupanuga Bhajan, Raganuga Bhajan. Without Raganuga Bhakti, we cannot satisfy Krishna. Even if we can recite the whole scriptures, Veda, Vedanta, Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudeva, Krishna is not satisfied. Krishna saying, those gopikas, when they are chiding me, go, why you are coming here? Then I become very satisfied. Even those Vedic hymns, when you are Shambed, Rigved, I am not satisfied. This way. So to love Krishna, to worship Krishna, we need one thing, heart. We'll have to give this heart to Krishna. This is the main point. Now I come back to Srila Madhavendra Puri Pada Smriti. Srila Madhavendra Puri Pada is the main pillar of our Gaudiya destiny. Main pillar. Though Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is Supreme Lord, no doubt. But still, Supreme Lord coming. But still, before coming, Krishna always sent some of his paraphernalia. Like any important king going, then before king going, when king going, then before some military man going, marching, backside, two side. So when Krishna appear, before coming, Krishna sent depute some of his personal associates like Madhavendra Puri Pada. And after Krishna disappear also, Krishna sent some of his personal associate to manifest a complete Leela. Because Leela is satisfied by devotees. Krishna doing Leela. But if there is no devotee, then it is not sweet actually. So actually when Madhavendra Puri Pada, actually Prabhupada telling, Madhavendra Puri Pada when speaking this slok, you must be sure this is the mood of Radharani. Then how Madhavendra Puri Pada speaking? Actually it is the mood of Radharani. Somehow by the mercy of Radharani, it appears in his heart and come out of his lotus mouth. Very nice look. So Prabhupada telling those who are doing Gaudiya Bhajan, they must have a clear conception about this, the mood of Madhavendra Puripad. Now point is that today is Chandan Yatra. I just touched this point. I can discuss this point after. Today is special day, Chandan Yatra. Actually, Madhavendra Puripad is the topmost Niskinchan Bhakta. He don't care for anybody, any material advantage, anything. So actually, Madhavendra Puripad, when reaching Govardhan, after doing parikrama, Govardhan parikrama, everything, when Madhavendra Puripad ultimately reaching Govinda Kunda, there Madhavendra Puripad taking rest beneath a tree. Madhavendra Puripad is so excellent Niskinchan devotee that we cannot compare Madhavendra Puripad with anyone. Yes, Sukadev Goswami is also about almost this kind of mood, you see. Sukadev Goswami never asks anything from anybody. Only three or four houses actually he go for begging. Actually he is not speaking anything. In front of one house he stand only for a few minutes. After that, if nobody watching, who is coming here, then he leave this place and go to another place by the desire of Krishna. And when somebody look, oh, some devotee coming, then he come with some bhiksha, I mean sela, don't take anything, only milk. Without asking, if anybody giving some milk, he can take. Otherwise not. This way, Madhavendra Puripad, now after doing parikrama, everything, now reaching Govinda Kunda. There he is sitting and doing Harinam Kirtan, not asking anything from anybody. After some time, before evening, Krishna Gopal Sinadji Sinadji coming and asking, why you are not asking anything from anybody? Why? Then Madhavendra Puripad looking at him, oh, so nice. In this material world, man, we have never seen this kind of boy. So beautiful. Nice, like beautiful, actually applicable for ladies. So you cannot say, so handsome, so nice. So after that, that boy speaking, Madhavendra was speaking, how you know I am fasting? Well, actually, I don't know. So those Matajis, they are going to Govinda Kunda to take water. So for a long time they are watching you and not asking anything. So they giving a pot full of milk, having giving to me and say, why you go to that Baba and keep this milk pot? That's why I am coming, actually. Actually, I don't know, you are fasting. Then actually Madhavendra Puripad took that pot. And that boy speaking, Gopal, okay, you drink milk. After some time, I can complete my seva and then come. I can come back and take the pot. I can take back. Okay, just check. This way, that boy gone. Then after that, Madhavendra Puripad drinking the milk, watching. That boy is not coming. A beautiful attraction is there. I cannot resist myself. So much attraction. Small boy. Who is that boy? So much attraction there inside. Hey, Krishna, he is attracted. Then after that, you see, midnight when Madhavendra Puripad doing chanting Harinam and little bit not actually sleeping, then Gopal, like your mother, Gopal coming in dream and speaking, Madhavendra, you couldn't understand. I went to you with milk. My name is Gopal, Srinath Gopal. Actually, I was installed by the grandson of Krishna, Vajranabho. I was installed by Vajranabho, and for so long time, my sevak, because those Muslim people, they usually attract village. So such a moment, my devotees, actually those who are worshipping, they put me inside one forest and they leave, because some Muslim came to kill them. So for so long time I am inside this forest. So I am looking for you, that you will come and serve me. I am looking for your service, seva. So now you are coming, so long after so long wait, you are coming. Then after that, Madhavendra Puripat get up and crying. Oh, Krishna coming, I couldn't identify, I couldn't understand. I am so unlucky. But anyway, Krishna giving one instruction, Gopal, that I am inside this forest. You please take me out, because there is rain, there is hot sunlight, so I am bearing there without seva. You please take the help of those Bhujavasis and go inside this forest. Here I am. Madhavendra, in dream, in Madhavendra Puripat, in dream, Gopal catching his hand, in dream, taking Madhavendra Puripat, come, I am here inside this forest. Oh, after that Madhavendra get up, then crying. After they thought, I will have to carry out the order of Gopal, I will have to do some seva. So in the morning time, he go to village and speak this, speaking about this dream in front of those Brajavasis, that your Gopal, inside this forest, our Gopal, yes, your Gopal here in Govardhan Dari. Govardhan Dari, he identified, he is inside this forest, come. He came in my dream last night, come. Let us take him out. Then all those young men, young chap of Javasis, they take shot, then go inside the forest and they find Gopal. Oh, they are dancing. They take Gopal, very heavy Gopal. They take outside the forest. After that, they take Gopal up Govardhan Hill with a stone plate. They make a singhasana, I mean throne, they make, and put Gopal there. After that, by the mercy of Gopal, actually Gopal speaking, for a long time I am not taking bath, nothing, you just please do seva. Then after that, Madhavendra Puripat, Govinda Kundu water, 108 pitcher, kalsi of water coming, all Brajavas is helping. Then Madhavendra Puripat doing Maha Abhishek. Actually, that Govinda Kundu, that water was created, you know when? In 10th canto you can find, when Krishna break the vanity of Indra Maharaj, when Krishna break the vanity of Indra Maharaj, then Indra crying and fall down in leg, please, I couldn't understand, please save me, excuse me. Now Surabhi also coming, with Surabhi, Krishna, because Indra is king, he's very clever. You know, no, I have done a great mistake, great offense. if I go myself, maybe Krishna cannot forgive me. So I will have to take the help of Surabhi, because Krishna become very satisfied with Surabhi, Gomata. So I must take the help of Surabhi. So taking Surabhi in front, Surabhi Devi, you go fast. I can go backside. Then after that, with Surabhi reaching this place, then seeing Surabhi, Krishna become satisfied. Gopal. After that, Indumaj fall down lake. He beg for pardon. Then actually, that Govardhan Dari, that Gopal, that time, which incident we find in Bhagavatam. There, Indra Maharaj, water of Akash Ganga. Akash Ganga means that water is there in space, not fall down. Ganga coming, Ganga Mandakini actually coming down, touching this earth. Akash Ganga means when it is waning, a falling state. There it take the water and come. Oirabad, you know, the elephant of where riding. Indra actually riding Oirabad, give instruction, Oirabad, you go. Take the water of Akash Ganga, I need. And Akash Ganga water need with no. Tongue. Oh, giving. Actually, Maha Abhishek was done. Whole Tirtha all over this world. The water was there for this Maha Abhishek. After that, milk, curd, everything. Clarified butter, everything. So after doing Mahabhishek, then big water, that water going to one pond, it was, that pond was created, that is Govinda Kunda. That pond is created by that water. So it is very holy. So now Madhavendra Puripad settled down his mind to serve Gopal very nicely. Now, after Maha Abhishek, everything done, then he arranged for Annakut, Annakuta big, rice, chapati, sabji, kad, sweet ball, oh, food, yogurt, everything. Then Madhavendra Puripad, when our Bhujavas is there, Brahman, they are cooking actually. And in puri, luchi, everything, I mean, they arrange different kind of sweets actually. They arrange. Then Madhavendra Puripad, when offering to Gopal, Madhavendra Puripad watching, Gopal is very hungry. He's taking all. Nobody can see. Only Madhavendra Puripad can see Gopal taking all. Oh, nobody can see. Gopal take. After that, those Brajavasi, one by one, Brajavasi, they are donating one cow for the service of Gopal. This way, 10,000 cow was there. 10,000 cows. Now my point, I can come back to this, this point of Chandan Yatra. Now my first point is there, that Madhavendra Puripad is the topmost Niskanchan devotee. Nita Siddha. But still, by the desire of Gopal, he was involved in this kind of seva. Automatically appearance is coming, 10,000 cows, so much temple, so much things coming. Actually, point is that, Prabhupada speaking, if you can reconcile your heart with Krishna, actually if you can reconcile your heart with Krishna, then and only then you can become happy. When you can become happy, actual happiness when can come? When your desire is totally harmonized with Krishna's desire. When your heart is totally harmonized with Krishna's heart. This way, if I can harmonize my heart with my Gurudev, then all different kinds of Siddhanta, Stata can flourish inside my heart. It's an automatic factor. Automatic factor. So somebody is speaking, asking to Prabhupada, how we can understand he is the actual servant of Guruji? Somebody asking to Prabhupada, how we can understand he is the actual disciple of his Guruji? How we can understand he is the actual devotee? I am actual doing service, giving service to Guruji. How we can understand? Prabhupada saying, when you can see that that disciple is doing seva, and by the mercy of Guruji, he has the power to catch all the power of Guruji. If you can watch, if you can discover that only this devotee, I mean this, there is so many devotees coming to Guruji, so many disciples coming, huh? But how I can know he is the actual disciple? Then Prabhupada giving answer, when you can see by the mercy of Guruji, he is getting whole power of Guruji, all siddhanta, all character, all vichar, I mean accurate. When you can see all siddhanta, everything, the desire of Guruji appearing inside the heart of that disciple, then you can understand he is actual disciple. Understand? So this is the point, actually. Some days before, I was discussing one point. I can go back to the Chandan Jata topics. Now in middle this point coming, so I should answer. Somebody asking, how we can know that Parikshit Maharaj is a disciple of Sukhdev Goswami? What mantra he took from Sukhdev Goswami so that you can say he is the disciple of Sukhdev Goswami? Somebody fighting with this point. And Prabhupada saying, what do you mean by Diksha? What do you mean by Diksha? Diksha means, if you have sambandha gains, sense of relationship, how to do seva, if you know, an ultimate goal, three kind of knowledge. There, then actually it is complete Diksha. Otherwise it is not actually complete Diksha. Prabhupada saying it is not, though you are taking mantra, but still this three, the sambandha gyan actually, sambandha avidya and prayojan. Three different knowledge is not coming inside your heart, then your Diksha is not actually perfect Diksha, Prabhupada speaking. So Prabhupada asking, what do you mean by Diksha? After hearing total Bhagavatam, Parikshit Maharaj developed this three knowledge, total, sambandha, avidya and prayojan. So actually, total Bhagavatam mean Krishna himself. Total Bhagavatam mean Krishna is no other than Bhagavatam. Shakshat Krishna evahi. Bhagavatam is Shakshat Krishna evahi. 100%. And when Guruji is giving you mantra, that mantra is also equal to Krishna. Kam Gayatri, Kam Beach. So when mantra become satisfied with your bhajan actually, then you can see the sarup of mantra. I mean you can watch Kamdev. You are doing Kam Gayatri mantra? Doing Kam Gayatri? When this mantra is Siddha, you become Siddha, then you can see mantra appear in front of you as Krishna himself. So mantra is equal to Krishna. So same thing, after hearing total Bhagavatam, Sukadev Goswami blessing, full blessing is there, with Parikshit Maharaj, there is so many evidence there. Because Sukadev Goswami appreciating Parikshit Maharaj. Varyane shate prasna kito lok hipo hito nipaha atmavit sanmataha pungsam satabhyadisu japaraha. Sukadev Goswami glorifying his disciple. Oh, you are really great. Because you have this kind of question, this kind of strong desire. This kind of question is rare in this material world. Nobody, everybody is inside illusion. They are all busy with Mayadevi, you see. Every day they are watching what is here, what is there. Everybody, they are busy with Maya. You will have to cut the relation of Maya totally. If you want to meet Krishna, if you want to get seva, nitya seva, then you will have to cut total relation with Maya. Total. Otherwise you cannot get Krishna. That day one question came. What that question? Because for Bhagavatam, it was on one just incident created by Jogumaya. Regarding Parikshit, first day I told you about Parikshit Maharaj, three four places in Bhagavatam you can find that Parikshit Maharaj is Mahabhagavat. So it is not possible for one Mahabhagavat to make any mistake. But still we find Parikshit Maharaj make one mistake. He put that dead snake inside around the neck of that Samik Muni, which is not possible for Parikshit Maharaj. Though he was thirsty and very hungry, but the symptom of Mahabhagavatam we find, a Mahabhagavatam never become dissatisfied on these points. Never. Even he is thirsty, even he is hungry, he never become angry. It is a symptom of Mahabhagavatam. Then how is that possible? That Parikshit Maharaj become very angry? Oh! Then he make one mistake. Then in commentary, actually Vishwanath Chakravarti Bhad, Srila Swami Bhad, they saying it was not actually a mistake. It was actually done by Krishna through his Jogumaya. Because otherwise we cannot hear Bhagavatam Pad Sukhdev Goswami. Just one instant, you see. Now, I have seen somebody explaining this way, that why Sukhdev Parikshit Maharaj make this mistake? Somebody saying, oh, Kali was asking for some place to stay. So gold is one place. Where, actually? This point is not actually perfect. Actually, you see, somebody can explain this way. Oh, actually, a crown was there made of gold. So that's why gold was there. The Koli took place there. So that's why his brain was out of order. If I explain this way, actually it is not good. Though it seems, it can be good, but it cannot be good. Because my first point is that when Rajasuya Yagya was there, who conducted this Rajasuya Yagya? Krishna himself. Though Rajasuya Yagya was done by Yudhishthira Maharaj, but still, by the desire of Krishna, it was done. And then that crown was touched by Krishna, and Krishna gave it. Krishna was the man, because in Rasya Yoga, Krishna was the first man whom all Muni Rishis they worship. On this point, there was big fighting with Shishupal. Shishupal saying, he is a useless fellow, Krishna. There are so many senior Rishi Munis there, mom. We should worship. Krishna is useless. We have doubt about his birth. Why we should worship Krishna? On this point, big fighting was there. Shishupal. But still, Krishna was worshipped. Anyway, my point is that actually Krishna approved this crown. Krishna put this crown after Abhishek. Because when Muni Rishis they do Abhishek, Yudhishthira Maharaj they do Abhishek to give this throne, actually when Yudhishthira Maharaj was giving this throne to sit and run this kingdom, then first of all Abhishek was done. It is a system. Then after Abhishek was done, that crown was touched by Krishna and it was given to Yudhishthira Maharaj's head. Now my point is that when Krishna touching this crown, Krishna approving this crown, inside that crown, Kali cannot have any right. This is a secret Siddhanta. How Kali can enter? Because in Chaitanya Chaitamrita is written, Jaha Krishna Taha Nahi Maya Radhika. Where Krishna is there, then Maya cannot enter. Maya means Kali. Kali have some package with Maya Devi. Kali have some package with Maya Devi. So Maya Devi cannot enter inside. So how it was done? It was done, created by Jogamaya to give us a big chance to hear Srimad Bhagavatam in details from the lotus mouth of Sukadeva Goswami. This point was not cleared that day. I couldn't make up my time to explain, so in middle light. So now I go back to Madhavendra Puribhaja's head. Actually, Parikshit Maharaj's whole desire is not personal desire. Any personal desire there in Parikshit Maharaj? No. Actually, Madhavendra Puripad, there is a fool in his kinchan. Still, by the mercy of Krishna, he was bound to accept this seva. So, big seva was there. Every day, Annakut. Though Annakut was the first day, that is written in Chaitanya Charitamrita. Oh, Maharaj, from the first day, same seva going on. Big. All Brajavas is coming with ghee and every all item they cook and offer to Krishna. That Sinath ji, that Gopal, is there now in Nathodwar, in Gujarat, one place. Nathodwar, that Gopal is there. They are in Nathodwar, in Gujarat. When Chaitanya Mahaprabhu went to Giriraj Maharaj in Vrindavan, then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu do parikram. After parikram, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself, Krishna, he is thinking, oh, how I can take the darshan of Gopal? I cannot go up because I cannot touch my leg with Giriraj. So how is possible to take darshan of Gopal? Then automatically, same day, previous night, Mahaprabhu thinking, same day, morning time, by the mercy of by the mercy of Jogamaya, Krishna coming down. How? Because automatically some fake news came. Oh, those Muslims coming to attack your village. Go with Krishna. Fake news. It's not actually true. Then Krishna coming down. Mahaprabhu, Gopal giving me mercy, coming down. Then after that, Gatholi Gaon. near Govardhan, one small village there, Gathuli Gao. There Chaitanya Mahaprabhu going and dancing whole day. Oh, Gopal coming to give him mercy. This way. Same. When Rupa Goswami Pad was old man, same thing happened. Oh, I cannot go up. How I can take darshan of Gopal? How possible? Then Gopal is again coming down and going to Mathura. And from one man, Rupa Goswami Pad, all his personal associate there, taking darshan of Gopal, doing archan, dancing, taking prasadam. So this way, actually Gopal, every time, actually, very merciful, every time, actually. That Gopal is there. Where? Gujarat, Nathodwar. I went there two or three times, actually. Very nice Gopal there, actually. So Nathodwar, actually, long distance. From Jaipur, you'll have to go whole night. And morning time you can reach. Morning time, whole night you will have to go. From Jaipur, bus service, this, they are very nice. So now, actually, Madhavendra Puripada is actually Krishna's desire. Krishna want to take seva from him. So Madhavendra Puripada now ready to do seva. He has his no personal desire. So one day, Madhavendra Puripada, actually, Gopal came in dream and speaking, Madhavendra, actually you are doing abhishek nicely, but still for long time I was getting rain and sunlight, so my body become very hot. So you arrange so that my body become cool. I cannot take rest. Krishna speaking this way. She cannot take rest. Oh, so you have to go to South India, Mysore. The Malaya Chandan special sandalwood. So we'll have to arrange that sandalwood for me and rub. And with water, you have all chandan, you put all body. Then I can become cool. Otherwise, not possible. And if you will have to go yourself. If you give this seva to somebody, it's not good. Because you have love for me, you will have to go. Then Madhavendra Puripada, actually, two devotees going from Bengal to Govardhan, they meet Madhavendra Puripada. Madhavendra Puripada was saying, so nice to Brahmin boys. Then Madhavendra Puripada initiate them and give this seva of Gopal, and he told. Then Gopal come in dream, giving me instruction, I will have to go in search of Chandan. I am in sandalwood. So you do this seva, so I am going. So Madhavendra Puripada, long way, 3,000 kilometers actually, more than 2,000 kilometers. Long way going to Orisha and from there. First of all he reached Kirchara Gopinath. Kirchara Gopinath there. First of all, Kirchara Gopinath. Kirchara Gopinath, you see that Kirchara Gopinath was installed by Ramchandra during his exile period. Ramchandra with Sita. One day, Ramchandra making one deity with arrow. What is this? Well, you cannot understand. Let me make this first. Then after that, Govinda, Gopinath, Madan Mohan, three deities. Ramchandra making. So I can appear this way. And this deity is now installed there. Kirchara Gopinath. You can see Govinda, Gopinath, Madan Mohan. Then Madhavendra Puripada. Now reaching Kirchara Gopinath, then the evening time is dancing and taking darshan of Aarti, everything done. After Aarti is over, 12 pots of special Kira, special, very special Kira, Indian cows, very special Kira. and offered to Gopal. After that, Madhavendra Puripad, the art is over. Madhavendra Puripad coming out of temple and thinking in mind, oh, it's so nice seva we are going on. If I can know the taste of Kira little bit, then I can go to Govardhan and offer accordingly. So how I can offer, how I can know the taste of Kira? Then after that, oh, very bad. I am a greedy personality. I am thinking about Kira. I should not speak, think that way. Then Madhavendra Puripad going outside. One market is there, village market. There he is sitting and doing kirtan all night. Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare. Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram. Then night side, night time, Krishna came in dream of Pujari. Pujari sleepy? Then Krishna came in dream. Gopinath, hey! Get up! Who? I am Gopinath. You go to temple and open. Why? Yeah, you can find one Kira, nice pot of Kira. By my Maya illusion, you couldn't understand. Every day you get pure pot of Kira. Now I take, I steal one for my devotee. He is sitting there in village market. You can go and search. His name is Madhavendra. Oh my God. Then Pujari get up, again take bath, go inside temple. Oh, you find one with clothes. Gopinath steal one Kira. Get one Kira, then go outside and close the door and go in market. Going in market, whose name is Madhavendra Puri? Please come and take this Kira. Because Gopinath giving instruction to me to hand over this Kira to you. Please identify yourself. Then Madhavendra Puri says, oh, my name is Madhavendra. Oh, your name. Oh, you are lucky. He fall down the stairs. You are lucky. Gopinath come in dream and giving instruction, go, he is my devotee, give this Kira. You are lucky. Oh, I like to take the food dust-off. Then he give this Kira. Same thing happened with my Guruji, Guru Maharaj. Guru Maharaj was there in Goaspur, in Nadia. One Nadia, one place, Kalyani. Well, Tenjani you can find one place. After Krishnanagar you can find Kalyani. There one Goaspur there, very nice place. Guru Maharaj someday worshipped Gopinath, very special Gopinath. Guru Maharaj one day forget to give blanket to Gopinath. And coming outside and taking rest, he become very cold. Why I feel cold today? I'm not fever, nothing. Then Gopinath coming in dream. Oh, you forget blanket from... Oh, I forget. And again take bath, go inside and excuse me, I forget. Take the blanket. Same thing happened. Same thing in my Guru Maharaj. So now Madhavendra Puri actually took this Kira. He took Kira. After that Kira, he washed the pot, take the water, again wash, then break it into pieces, very small pieces, powder, and put inside this cloth here. And every day, one piece of that pot, one small piece, put in tongue, then one kind of special ecstasy, love coming inside, crying, prema. Every day that broken piece, if taken inside mouth, you're feeling a special kind of prema coming, like flood. Oh, every day. So this way, after that, Madhavendra Puripa thought, morning time, then Pujari can speak, he has a special devotee. Krishna came in dream, so they can give me pratishtha, they can wash my leg, give garland, it is good. Night time I can fly from here. So night time, Madhavendra Puripad leave this place. Morning time everybody can come and take me, and worship me. It's not good. I must leave this place. So leave this place. And after that, walking, walking, going to Puri. And after going to Puri, those big, big panda, those were in charge of Jagannath Math. Then Madhavandi were going to everybody, speaking in Govardhan, actually, in Vrindavan. Gopal came in dream. He is asking from Chandan. I am in Chandan, special sandal. So how I can arrange? Because I am sannyasi, I have nothing. Okay, we can arrange. We can inform king and we can get Chandan. So then after that, from king, they got lot of Chandan. They pack it and hand it over to Madhavendra Prabhu. Okay, you take it. And some kampur, special kampur, not chemical kampur, special kampur. And that special kampur and chandan was handed, was given to Madhavendra Puripad. Madhavendra Puripad is old man, you see. So love inside, he cannot calculate the how I can give this heavy luggage and go to Govardhan. So much love. When tremendous love is there inside your heart, then no kind of argument can stand. I told you that day. No argument stand. I love Krishna. I can do anything for Krishna. So I couldn't calculate how I can take this heavy chandan sandalwood. How? Anyway, he after that. Somehow he reached again a Kirchura Gopinath. Night time took rest. They give Kira everything to him because now he is known face. Because they respect him very much. Then after that, are you see in dream again Gopinath came. Gopal. Srinath. Gopal saying, Madhavendra, you are taking a big trouble for me. Oh, you love me so much. So now I get all bundle of sandalwood, kampur, everything. I'm very satisfied. You need not come up to Govardhan. You can apply in my body. Gopinath, I am here. Gopinath and me, same. So you can rub chandan whole month. And you can apply sandal, I mean, in my body. Be sure, my body and Gopal, same. So don't express any doubt inside. Please accept my request. Because Gopal was so merciful. Gopal thought, Madhavendra is so great devotee, he loved me so much. How he can come so long way up to Vrindavan to apply this chandan? So I should be merciful to him. Become merciful. I give all chandan, sandal, everything. And Madhavendra Puripad apply this chandan to Gopinath's body. 21 days. 21 days. 3 weeks. That the mode, I mean that service, now still we Gauriyas, we are running. That's called Chandan Yatra. And in Puri you can find the Chandan Yatra special. Jagannath also going to Chandan Sarovar and he is like king in a boat. he is enjoying fresh air. Chandan. Jagannath Madan Mohan going on boat and for up to late at night. Oh, Madan Mohan, with Chandan, everything is enjoying and moving around this Chandan Sarovar lake. Nice. This way, Chandan Jatha, if you go, you can see every day, evening time, Madan Mohan coming and going to Chandan Sarovar every day. So this way, we get the seva at the time of Mahaprabhu also. This way, we Chandan Jatha coming to us. Today is Akshaya Tritiya. Akshaya Tritiya is special day. Actually, there in Himalaya, Himalaya there, Bodhinarayan. You heard about Bodhinarayan? No? Bodhinarayan. In Narayan form, Krishna is there. Bodhinarayan, hilly place. Alakananda coming, Mandakini, you can get the stream of Mandakini there in Kedarnath, where Mahadev Shankar, Shankar, Mahadev is there. There you can get the stream of Mandakini. Here Alakananda. So there you can find two hills. One is Noro Narayan, two hills, side by side. Two big hill mountain. One is Noro, another is Narayan, Noro Narayan. They are taking the form of hill, they are doing astuti and penances for the benefit of all this material world. That place. Bodhinarayan. Understand? That Bodhinarayan, today is a special day. When Bodhinarayan can start taking seva from material people. I mean, pujaris, those who are doing pujari. 6 months, for 6 months, for 6 months, Bodhinarayan taking seva from demigods. For 6 months, Bodhinarayan taking seva from demigods, they coming and worship Bodhinarayan. And for another 6 months, those are human being, I mean pujaris, those are the, they can worship for 6 months. Today is a special day. And another point, today is the special day when Satyayug was installed. Satyayug started. Today is the day. Akkhaya Tritiya day, Satyayug started. Actually, started means it's a recurring factor actually. Satya, Teta, Dapar, Kali, Satya. Satya, Teta, Dapar, Kali, Satya. So rotating factor. So when Satyayug appear again, it's a today, Akkhaya Tritiya day. Today is the day when barley, we say actually paddy, barley, you know, wheat, you know, actually this today, it was created by Brahma. So special day. Special day today. So very nice. And actually by the Siddhanta of Srila Keshava Goswami Maharaj and Prabhupada, our Gurudev, they say today is a special day. If you do any special seva today, it becomes eternal in nature. Very morning time I today came here. Whole day I am doing seva today, whole day. Morning time first, after doing bhajan, doing my worship there in ashram. Then I come back fasting, do the worship of Sivji Maharaj, give water, everything, full. After that I go to my Guru Maharaj Samadhi, Gupuja. After that I come back again to ashram, take sai, then go to Nisingatala. There I worship, I do everything, whole day. After that, somebody sent car, I go to Krishnanagar, some special case, then again I come back, again take bath, then I come to you. Whole day. Again, now I will go to library to do some seva, whole day. So today, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, I will do parikrama because daytime I couldn't make up a time. So today is a special day. If you do any nice seva, then it becomes eternal in nature. Eternal in nature. Any seva you do today, it become eternal in nature. So big, powerful, actually. So today is the day when Param Pujyavat Keshava Goswami Maharaj, my Guru Pad Padma, I mean non-different from my Guruji, he started Gaudiya Vedanta Samiti today. Akshaya Tritiya day. With a nice mood, that if I start Vedanta Samiti today, then I can get the, enjoy the mercy of Krishna, and I can go on preaching my Siddhanta, Gauriya Siddhanta, for infinity period. Even if I go away from this material world, maybe some of my disciples can come and speak the same thing as I tell. So this way, today is a special day, Akshaya Tritiya day. So the Gauriya Vedanta Samiti was started today in a rented room in Calcutta, Bosparra Lane. Calcutta, Bosparra Lane. Where Bagbhair Gauri Mutt, you know Bagbhair Gauri Mutt? Calcutta? Just near. Bagbhair Gauri Mutt? You been there? Huh? You went there? Ah. Just near. 5 minutes only. Here Gauri Mutt? Just cross the road, come this thing, there. In a rented room. That time no money was there, nothing. Only heart was there, full of desire. I will do seva for Gauranga Mahaprabhu, this much. I understand my point? Today is a special day. So today actually Satya Yug started. Today is the day when Badrinarayan's open temple today, from today for 6 months, up to Kartik, I think. Seva. Now I like to discuss one point. You can get a big lesson from this teaching, you see. From this Siddhanta. Actually, when I din Dardanath Mathuranath, this slok, when Madhavendra Puripad speaking, Madhavendra Puri was crying, last age actually, old age, is crying, Oi Dindyadanathe Mathuranath, Kadavalaka Sehidem Tadaloka Kadaram, Daito Brahmati Kim Karamiham. What I can do? Without you, I am going to die just now. Without you, I cannot live. Oi Dindyadanathe Mathuranath. Now Madhavendra Prabhupada speaking this sloka, but this the actual sloka is coming from Radharani. Mathuranath, what do you mean by this sloka? You follow this point? Radharani speaking actually. By the mercy of Radharani, it appears into the heart of, it manifests into the heart of Madhavendra Prabhupada. Actually this sloka is by Radharani. Oi Dindyardhanadi Mathuranath. Now point is that why Radharani or Madhavendra Paripad speaking Oi Dindyardhanadi Mathuranath? You are full of mercy. You are Mathuranath. You are not looking at me. I am just going to die. Then why Radharani or Madhavendra Paripad speaking Mathuranath? What is the reason behind it? What is the reason behind it? You know? This deep feeling of separation. Now we have gone to Mathura. We are suffering very much. Come and look how much we are suffering. You are now gone, you have gone to Mathura. This sense of separation, deep feeling, is expressed in this sloka. This deep sense of separation is expressed in this sloka. Deep feelings. Now you forget us. We are Brajavasis, we are Gopikas. We are not educated. Maybe you can get a lot of educated ladies, Gopikas there in Mathura. Mathura is a city. We are coward, actually. So, we don't know how to serve you properly. Maybe for this reason you leave us, our seva, and going to think. Maybe they are educated, they are highly qualified to do your seva. Maybe we have no quality to do your seva. That's why you leave us here. We are now in the ocean of separation. So much we are suffering. Come and look us. Save us. Save us. Otherwise we are going to die very shortly. We cannot live anymore. This Mathuranath is this word Mathura, Aidindyadha Mathuranath. It is expressed in a very, very many loveful way. Now you are Mathuranath. Now you have gone to Mathura. You are Mathuranath. You leave us. That's why, out of love, they are saying, oh, you leave us. Aidindyadha Mathuranath. When I can look you, this is the only medicine you can arrange to save us. Otherwise, there is no medicine. Without you, we are going to die. So much nice philosophy there in Uddhava Gita, Uddhava Sandesh. If I get chance, I can discuss this point one by one. Very nice point I can discuss. Very sweet point. Now, I like to discuss about one Siddhanta here. Lila in Chaitanya Charitamrita. When Madhavendra Prabhupada speaking this sloka is the last moment, last stage, I mean before leaving this material world. That time Ishwar Puribad was doing his personal seva. Ishwar Puribad was doing this personal seva of Madhavendra Prabhupada. It is my request, don't go to pure devotees and stay there for a long time. If you find one small, if you discover some fault, is big aparadha for you. Actually, those who are pure devotees, they have no fault. When some of our Guru Varga used to take permission from Prabhupada, give permission, please. We like to take darshan of Bhaktisiddhanta Babaji Maharaj there. Prabhupada said, no! Don't go there! Why? If you can go there, you can discover some fault with him. You can go down. Actually, they are Bhaktisiddhanta Babaji Maharaj. Actually, they are Paramahansa, pure devotees. You cannot understand what they are doing. So you can find fault, you can go down. Don't go. When they are doing what thing, you cannot understand. This way, don't go too near to pure devotees, or too long. Even if you go, here he comes, don't stay for long. If you find some fault, dangerous, very dangerous. Try to accept their Siddhanta, try to understand their heart, mood of seva, try to follow them properly, then there is no mistake. Understand? So this way, actually, Ishwar Puripat was a personal seva of Madhavendra Puripat. But Madhavendra Puribad, last moment, old age, you see, he cannot get up. He is passing stool and urine there in bed. If you look, you can say, you can speak. You can think this way. Then big aparadha. Big aparadha. Actually, those pure devotees, if they are passing stools and urine, is also not material. Be careful. See, if you become very, then it is dangerous for you. So Madhavendra Puripat, last moment playing this lila, and Ishwar Puripat with loveful attitude, loveful mood, washing clothes, cleaning Gurudev, everything, doing, arranging, always speaking Harikatha, reciting Bhagavatam, and Gurudev enjoying. Oh, so nice. sometimes giving prasadam, soft prasadam, milk and everything. Milk actually, milk only milk. Without milk, Madhavendra Prabhupada never take it. Clean, always recite Bhagavatam, then Gurudev become very satisfied. Then he give mercy. I bless you. You can give the whole treasure, love, treasure of bhakti. So by the mercy of Madhavendra Prabhupada, Ishwar Kribad getting whole treasure from the heart of Gurudev, is getting everything. But one disciple, his name is Ramchandra Puri. Ramchandra Puri is a very critical man, very sceptic minded, always express doubt for Guru Vaishnava and Bhagavan. His heart is not clear. Always express doubt. In front of Gurudev, he is giving advice to Gurudev. Oh Gurudev, who are you? Are Siddha. You can enjoy Brahma Sukha, Brahma. Why you are crying? You think who you are? You are always enjoying Brahma Sukha. Gurudev become very angry. Idiot! Go away from me! Don't show your face to me anymore. If I see your face, then I cannot go to Krishna. Go away! Because he is advising Gurudev. Oh my God! He is so foolish. In Hari Bhakti Vilas, it is written, in front of Guru Vaishnava, you must hang your head and stand this way. Don't speak much. Don't speak a lot. Don't try to exhibit that you are a great Pandit. You are a learned man. Don't so. In front of Gurudev, I am an ass. I am an ass. I know nothing. Foolish. So in front of Gurudev and Vaishnav, we must express this humble mood. If you go through, that day I told you, you all must go through Jaiva Dharma. It's vital. And I told 12 books that day. I forget to speak about Bhajan Rahasya. I forget to speak about Harinam Chintamani. But this is complete. Now you 14 or 16 books, you go. And first of all, Jaiva Dharma. In Jaiva Dharma you can find some Bhajanandi, some Paramahansa devotees, they are doing bhajan there in Gadroom, where you went to search me. That is the exact place. I don't know why Krishna take me from Vrindavan and I will stay there. Gurudev Bhava Kripa Kori Gaura Banamaje Gadrume Diyacho Stan. Nice. So I don't know why. I was there in Surjakundi, here they should enjoy. But those senior devotees say, Maharaj, your Gurudev giving you this seva. So you go back. You can come here after you do. Then after that I am doing seva. Then I get this, somebody arrange for me this. They make some room small, I start writing. This way my seva. All editing, everything in the name of Gopinath Gauriyaman, my Guru Maharaj's name, I was doing. So this way, actually, point is that in front of Guru Vaishnav, we must be very humble. We should not express. We cannot speak a lot. We can miss in front of Shuddha Vaishnava. If I go and give a nice lecture to him, then I am a foolish. I must be in a very humble mood. I can keep silence. Then automatically he can speak something, which is the treasure for me. If I go on giving giving one less lecture in front of Gurudev, then I am going to miss. He cannot speak anything. Then he can stop. So it is the rule. In Bhagavatam, first kanda, Naradji previous life, if I get chance, I can discuss. When Gurudev finds this Shishya is a very sober personality, then Gurudev becomes very merciful. Oh, he is very sober. He is very humble. I must give all property to him. That is a special place. When in Jaiva Dharma you can find some Bhajanandi, some Paramahansa devotees, they used to do bhajan there. That is the exact place. Then one sannyasi, Mayavadi sannyasi from Varanasi, a long history, I can speak you after, or I can speak now, they can enjoy. From Varanasi, is a big sannyasi, a very learned man, Veda, Vedanta, Upanishad, all big. One day he was doing bhajan, inside in bhajan kuti, very small bhajan kuti. Suddenly, in the morning time, he find one nice devotee crying and these tears rolling down his cheeks and doing this kirtan. Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhara Sivasadi Gaur Bhakta Binda Sri Krishna Chaitanya. Suddenly, with kartal, he is doing and crying. Then when Mayavadi sannyasi is from Bhajan Kutir, he is watching. Who is he? So nice devotee. Is crying? Then I must go and meet that devotee. He is very lucky. Then after that, he thought, oh, I am big Acharya. I am big Acharya in Mayavadi Sampradaya. If I go there and somebody looks, see, I am meeting Vaishnava, they can decry me. They can criticize me. So I shouldn't go. I am the guru of 10,000 disciples. If somebody looks, oh, Gurudev going to meet one Vaishnava, it is very derogatory for me. It's not good. So I cannot go. I must stay. After Thaksana said, no, I must go. I have the chance to meet him. I must go. This way, friction going on inside his heart. I should go. I should not go. No, I should go. No, I cannot go. If I go astray. This way, sometime gone. And within this period, that Vaidya Vaishnav doing kirtan, you went to Varanasi? Never? Need not go. You can get everything here. I am speaking. You can say Varanasi is the oldest city in India. There, small land, very small land. Even one man cannot enter properly. There are so many lands. The Vaishnav doing kirtan, I don't know which land Vaishnav enter and vanish. Then ultimately, that Mayavadi sannyasi took decision. Oh, I must meet. Anybody can, if somebody can criticize me, what it concerned to me, I must meet him. Then go outside and searching for the Vaishnava. Where is that Vaishnava? We don't get it. Because by that time it was too late, and Vaishnava entering too late, he's just crying, oh, I got the chance. Now I miss. Oh, I'm so bad luck. But still, be careful what I mean to say. He missed his chance, but still he was lucky. Because he heard Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhara Sivasadi go from the lotus mouth of that pure devotee. That is transcendental sound. So that transcendental sound give one permanent impression into the heart of that Mayavadi Sanyasi, pah! Stamp! Give stamp! He couldn't forget. Oh, I must go to Navadvip. Oh, for a fraction of a second I feel what kind of love, what kind of treasure that Paramahansa Vaishnavas enjoy. I must go to. Because in Varanasi there is no love. Only Brahma, Chaitanya, only logic, fighting. I must leave this place. I can go to Navadi. Going to Navadi. He was bound to come to Navadi. You see the power of transcendental sound vibration. Only for a fraction of a second, he meet that Vaishnava, meet the look that Vaishnava. And with, at the same time, darshane pavitra kara itamar gun. Whenever you see the lotus feet of one Vaishnava, you become very pure. Otherwise, you will have to go to Ganga and take bath, then you become pure. And if you look at Vaishnava, instantly you become pure. So power. Then after that, what happens? That Mayavadi Sanyasi was bound to come here in Navadvip as if some unknown force catching, pulling him to Navadvip. He coming Navadvip and asking where I can meet those pure devotees there staying here, Paramahansa. Oh, you cross this road, take bath in Ganga. And cross the door, you can go to God room. You can find so many pure devotees there doing kirtan whole day. Oh, really? Then he cross the rope, cross the river, take bath, and go and searching for Vaishnava. And he meet Paramahansa Babaji Maharaj. First of all, in 2-3 pages, if you read Jaiva Dharma, you can find him. Why I quote this example from Jaiva Dharma? This example by Bhaktivinoda Thakur. From Jaiva Dharma I'm speaking. I give example because pure devotee is so powerful. Even if I stay thousands of miles away from pure devotees, if they bless me, they speak powerful. They can give influence. So that is the Gadum. Where this Mayavadi Sanyasi, he came and first meet Paramahansa Babaji Maharaj. Babaji Maharaj said, Babaji Maharaj, Paramahansa Babaji, catch him, embrace him. Oh, I am a fallen soul. Why you pay dandavat to me? You are Sanyasi, you are great. But no, I like to take shelter until your lotus feet. Don't speak that way. Oh, I must take shelter. Then after that, Paramahansa Babaji Maharaj give blessings to him, give kippa. Then after that, his name was Vaishnav Das. His name was Vaishnav Das. That name was given by Paramahansa Babaji Maharaj. From today, your name is Vaishnav Das. Oh, really? Now, from today, he is no Mayavadi. He shave his head. He do kirtan, hear Harikatha, doing Harinam, chanting and dancing. He is enjoying now. Now, that Vaishnav Das was big educated man previously, but still he was Mayavadi. Now by the mercy of Paramahansa Gurudev, all Siddhanta coming inside his heart. Paramahansa Babaji, that Vaishnav Das. Then Vaishnav Das become the vital personality of Godrum Dham. If somebody coming from distant place to fight with Vaishnavas, then all Vaishnavas say, you will have to do judgment with them. Sit here. I cannot fight with them. No need of fighting. They can speak negatively, you can speak because you are learned in them. Now you are big Vaishnav. You have very humble attitude. Then that Vaishnav does become great Vaishnav. That time, Pradyumna Mishra, Padunna Mishra, the personal associate of Gauranga Mahaprabhu. That time he was there in Nishingapalli. He was doing there, bhajan there. That time, I am speaking, not it is a story. Not it is a fictitious story. It's true. That time, Bhaktivinoda Thakur is saying, that time, that that time he was Pradyumna Brahmachari was doing bhajan there. And Paramahansa Bhaji Maharaj was the disciple of that Pradyumna Brahmachari. I mean personal associates of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. This way, maybe you are coming from long way, but still you can become successful if you can protect your devotee, devotion. Pure devotion is very, very rare. If you run here and there, if you meet somebody, you can lose your bhakti. That day I told you, give indication. You will have to give full protection of to maintain pure devotees, pure devotion. Keshav Goswami is telling. Keshav Goswami is telling, by chance, by the mercy of Guru Vaishnava, if you get pure devotion, please try to protect in a very heavy way. Slight mistake there, you can lose your bhakti. So many negative things going here. Be careful. What is negative? What is positive? You cannot identify. Be careful. You will have to protect pure devotion. Because it is a rare. It's the only property in this 14 world. The only property. If I get a trace of love for Krishna, is actual property. Actual is actual property. In Bhagavatam, I can discuss this point sometime after, because now I have no time. Mai bhaktir hi bhutanam amritathaya kalpate. My devotion is actual nectar. Krishna speaking to Uddhava. Uddhava is actual nectar. And if you enjoy nectar, nobody can kill you. Nobody can kill you. Parikshit Maharaj, last time speaking, let that snack, takak, let that takak come now and bite me. I don't care, because I am already enjoying nectar. So this is the point. Today, time is limited. I will have to go to library, everything. So I finish. If you have any question, you can ask. Vancha kalpataruvasya ke pasindh vavishya paditanang pavanu bhavishna bhyo namo. Actually, I put question, I give answer. So, I think it's clear. You must hear very attentively. Very clearly you should understand this point, otherwise big problem. So I can discuss some point about how to do pure bhajan after some time, because at present I don't have time, I am busy. Vancha kalpataruvasya ke pasindh vavishya paditanang pavanu bhavishna bhyo namo. Next time I cannot speak now. Nisinga Chaudhasi, actually, how long it is? How 10 days due? 10 days. Okay. Nisinga Chaudhasi day or... Before I can try. If I make up my time, my mother can come halfway, I can come halfway. Okay? I can come halfway, you can come. Take the trouble to come halfway. It's good. Who? Oh, actually it is very problem, because they are taking education now. You can lose. Actually, I have great love affair with Shankar Bhagavan, Shiva. My mother doing 36th year full fasting, Chaturdasi, previously, in my home. Then after that I took bath. Monday, at the month of Shankar, this way, summer. my month. Actually, not Vaisakh, Chaitra, previous month. So I have some love with Shankar. He, Shankar Bhagavan, always protecting me. So I have some special case with Shankar. I can come. No problem. So bless me.